Dragon Shire.
Your team bans first. Okay. Bans. I'll ban Probius. He performs well right now, and he could be pretty good on Dragonshire as well. As well as against the hero that I might want to be picking. Grubby, what is this tournament server used for on the BNet app? For tournaments. They are able to use the patch that is tournament ready, which is basically nothing that's been out for the last 2 weeks. They need it because when they release a new hero, new balance, they don't want all the hard practice to suddenly be partially invalidated with a tournament match coming like a day after the patch, so they need that. I can't take Genji. Maybe I'll remove him from favorites?
Greetings, friend. Tremble before me.
So?
Here we go again.
So the Johanna really couldn't pick Genji either. So Genji can only be played on Hanamura or what?
Fight time.
Damn it. New Uther then.
The light abandons no man.
I'll go for the new Uther then.
Okay.
So you can quick match him and you can play him on Hanamura.
I hear the call.
Oh yeah, maybe you just can't play him in custom game.
Let the battle begin. Good form. Hero of the storm. Victory. Okay, prepare. Everybody, let the battle begin. Good form.
Hero.
Okay.
Let the good
hero.
Okay.
Let the good
hero victory.
Okay.
Let the good
hero victory.
Okay. Let the good girl victory. Oh, you can't draft him. That makes sense. So you can set up Genji in a quick match. That makes sense. Okay, okay. They have Brightwing Chromie. What should I ban? Uther, Nazebo, Diablo. Maybe just ban the Haka? I don't know. Maybe I should have banned Anubarak? Because we have... If they Anub need to... Take range AA Janker and the solo laner still.
We will forge a great destiny.
That's a nice Samuro skin. This is the beta Anderson Plus.
I stand ready.
Wow, new Vala skin. Nice. Okay, so they don't have a solo laner. They can use a Nubarak for it. That's okay. He wants Samuro. We need solo laner. Can you solo a Sam? I don't think it's ideal, but if he wants to, I'm going to let him. Okay, go ahead. This is fine then.
Impressive, am I not?
Very much. Very much.
I serve.
Why did he laugh twice? He laughed when Zerato got picked. Okay, so what would they take? Maybe they can go in Uberak. They can go for Tassadar. Actually, Tassadar would be great for them in the final pick. He did get banned, though. I mean, he did get nerfed a bit, but there we go. Tassadar solo lane or Brightwing, and the other four in a rotation. Okay, so new Uther. I've tried two of them so far. One is the Holy Light build and one is the Hammer of Justice build. Hammer of Justice, you get CDR on your hammer every time you auto, and you get mana for autos. You can get slows and damage reduction on opponents for hammer at level 13. You can get a speed increase on yourself from a hammer. Level 7 is a kind of cleanse protect tier. Okay, so we have that. Do I want to slow any one of them? It will be so-so. We don't have a lot of slows yet, per se. Only Zeratul's W. So it could be nice. I should not imagine I can get too close to Vala, Chromie, or Brightwing. Rather, I should probably want to Divine Shield either Samuro with Bladestorm or Diablo. For the rest, I need a lot of sustain heals to deal with Chromie and Vala's poke, as well as Tassadar shields, storms, and arcane flares. They have good poke, better than us, since we have four melee. So I need my heals very much. I can go for Q range, Q mana cost reduction, or I can go for a W build. It's the only thing I haven't tried yet. I'll take a quick look at it to refresh myself on its utility. It could be nice for the four-man rotation. Might just be what I need. All right, let's look at the level one Wave of Light. If I heal or damage a lot, I get an increase in duration of devotion. And devotion is armor after you heal something or someone. That could be nice. And also, there's a passive mana cost and cooldown reduction. Okay, that seems to be the one to take here. I'll get Wave of Light. Right. Keep in mind that Uther had an entire rework. So Holy Light is now not quite like Tyrande, but a little bit similar. You can either heal yourself for 400 HP, or you can heal someone else for 400 and yourself for 200 at the same time. And when you do that, both you and your ally get the armor. Nice job. Oh,
that was a good one.
Okay, we get the heals, we get the quest stacks. We get that globe. Void Insanity just left his Samuro. Hopefully he comes back. Give him a few seconds. Void Insanity, you coming back? Oh, he's back. Okay, you're back. Great. Go, go. Oh, okay. Okay.
The ancient shrines.
I will heal Zeratul.
And let loose the Dragon Knight.
Take down! Diablo seems fine, but Vala is bullying him a bit. I have a heal, and there we go. Damaging and healing. Oh, that's close. That's really close. We need to get out of here.
Activate the shrines and the
dragon. That's three quest stacks. Who has the most mana? It's Zera. I give him a heal. This one is only on heroes, I think, the quest. Oh yes, damage or heal hero, so you can't farm it on minions. Quickly gonna go down here. Samuro seems to be doing fine. I will heal him and heal all of them. I am still out of mana. Can still happen, as any healer, Uther included. That's because they have so much poke. Let's see if we can get Chromie here. Or Brightwing, maybe. So as Uther, the new Uther, you might want to make sure not to heal one person too fast by two separate heals, as you would waste the duration of your devotion, which is a 2-second 25 armor. Let's see. Damage to nearby enemies, or a Holy Shock can deal damage, which is a poke. And it's a way to proc something else that we can get later. Or I get Hammer of Justice makes my movement speed go up.
Fate demands this one's death.
It depends what I want to take later. Okay, stop them long enough and I'll go back. I think I want Pursuit of Justice.
For the light.
But it's not that good. 20% is very little. Let's just go Holy Shock. Gives us some other option. It makes it cost far less mana, your Holy Light, and it's on a short cooldown. It's a nice little bit of poke damage. I definitely can't take it. I'm going to poke Vala 240 damage. Need that globe. Go back and I'll try to get the Dragonite. Nope. Okay, I will, Lily. So, when they are stunned, rooted, or silenced, that is when I can give them extra armor. Or I have a cleanse on a long cooldown. I feel like we should try that one. Hand of Protection. I now have cleanse. It's on a 90-second cooldown. But if I auto-attack, I'll shave off 5 seconds every time. And it's also the first time I'm trying it. That's a lot of quest stacks. I will heal him before he goes in and takes damage. He has a bit of armor now. Nice. So the cool thing is, Samuro's images, for once, help quest stacking for his own team. If you go for Wave of Light, you can use Samuro's images for quick hero stacking. That's kind of cool, because normally opponents abuse it. I need to keep my cleanse ready for the crucial times, and then we can see how it works. Oh, Varian is rotating up. The bush here is gone. I'm going to give him a heal. Oh, yep, there we go. And, nice. I keep my cleanse hand ready.
Now.
Get the globe. Okay, nice.
You're on a roll.
Yeah! Right. To the top. We're never gonna quit. My cleanse is ready. Just waiting for that moment.
I like it.
Cleansed. 70-second cooldown. You don't want to use your auto attacks in here though. 40 seconds, 36. I go Divine Shield and I'll try to get this thing. Nice, got it. Shouldn't be the support, but oh well. Oh, that's... Oh, it doesn't work on Dragonite too well. I'll just keep kicking Varian. This seems like a really good version of Cleanse. It's not always safe to auto-attack, which is cool. It creates variants. The good kind of variants. Nice. Okay, so that was cleanse. Very useful. I'm gonna rotate here to the bottom lane. Nazebo is not going back yet for some heals. We have 53 stacks out of 60, by after which we will get the quest reward, which is the increased duration.
Okay.
Are they doing this camp? No, we actually see four of them on the map. It creates variance. I didn't mean it that way. Okay, 56. Give him a heal. And my cleanse is coming back, and it's back. So the W cooldown is 12 seconds, and you shave off 1 second per hero hit. Or, yeah, damage or heal.
No potion.
Armor affected life, and it's gone. So let's look at my cooldown. It's 12 normally, and like this is 8. Okay. Get some mana back as well. I shouldn't forget I have Holy Shock either. I still have cleanse.
Unleash the dragon's wrath.
I have cleanse, but no opportunity to use anymore. Cleansed, that's good. Divine shield, had to. I will go what? Oh yes. Oh, holy light! Holy shock. Blessed champion is a... is a nice synergy with Holy Shock. Holy Shock can put your Q on a 6 second cooldown instead of 12. I'll just give him one heal before I go. And then this one gives you 5 seconds of auto attacks that heal Uther and everyone around him for the amount healed. Oh, for the amount healed. Okay, so Holy Shock, the damage. Yeah, yeah. Okay, so the self-healing procs. So it's not nearly as much as when you heal someone, Blessed Champion. In fact, quite a lot less. Yeah, okay, so. Do I instead want Spell Armor or Well-Met? Well, Well-Met is actually pretty good, but I don't have the proc quest for it. So I will still go for Blessed Champion. 4 more heals. It is probably needed here. I'll keep my cleanse ready. Do I need my cleanse? Well, I used it, but it didn't do that much. I have Divine Shield if I need. Oh! Sound decision. 49 heals on Diablo. Hoppa! Alright. That was close.
This is the end for you.
No, I need to go back. And so does Diablo. I'm getting my cleanse back. I need Fountain Care. And we got it. Got the Dragonite. Okay. So Well-Met is like half a shrink rate every Hammer of Justice, which is on an 8 second cooldown. Not bad actually. Half a shrink rate for 3 seconds. But we don't have Hammer of the Lightbringer CDR, which would just make it crazy and must pick. Yeah, Blessed Champion, a bit more heals. Okay. Increase Holy Light self healing when you're under half life. You get triple the self heals. Or Holy Radiance increases healing received. Allies healed by Holy Radiance received. Okay, let's do that one. If we W someone first, then Q, they get bonus heals. Let's try it out. 300, 997 instead of 712. That's pretty nice. I don't know if it's good enough though. I don't know if it's good enough. 40% more heal. You must heal them in that order. And it says all sources, which means Uther and other people. But still. I know Beacon of Light is great. I've tried it before. It's, you gotta be low HP. And when you use it, you know, it's fantastic. You get 1150 heal if you heal someone else. For 700, 800, you get 1150 yourself. It's great. But now, 741. Wrong order, obviously. We should probably backstab them. Cleanse so he can stay on. Divine Shield so he can stay on. Oops. Oh no, he pushed him away. I was gonna get him maybe. Ah. Ah, that was close. Oh. That's a big heal, 1078. And also the auto attacks that I keep doing could heal Diablo for extra. So that's nice. So there's a potential of a lot of healing in the right circumstance.
Right. For Lordaeron.
And we should just siege it down.
Dragon awaits, heroes. Free him and destroy your enemy.
See, I'm healing him for 339 per hit. Wow. Why? That's so much. That's a great interaction. That's a great interaction. Why was it that much? I guess it just is. Cleanse. First trait value of the game. Give everyone armor. Give everyone healing. He has armor. Give him some healing. And him some more? No. So 50% on the core, not bad.
Watch for a while. Keep up the, presumably, good work.
Thank you very much, Scary Gimmicks. So, why was it the healing bonus double dip? So, let's try to see what happened. Allies healed by Holy Radiance receive 40% increased healing from all sources. Then we cue him. So, he gets 1,000 from the cue. And in every attack, oh, because he healed for that much, Uther, 1,000 on an ally plus another 400 on yourself, but you also W'd yourself, so the 400 is actually 480. Is it 480? No, 560. So you do 560 on yourself, 1120 on someone else, thanks to all that, and then when you hit, oh, that's right, yeah, it's a double dip bonus. Well, that's a really strong interaction. Here I go for divine protection. The devotion stacks twice, so he has 50 armor right now, Zeratul. So strong. I can't do the math now, but it is pretty awesome is what I know. So you heal him, like, oh, well, that's it. GG. 57,000 heal. Nice sustained heals. Of course, it was a bit of a snowball, but it shows off just one build for Uther here. And I couldn't have quite predicted his Thanos to interact like that, but it makes sense. The level 13 Beacon of Light. functions off of the total amount healed in your previous one. And you're buffing that with your level 16. So this kind of puts an amplified healing on someone. And then you amplify heal them. And this is on yourself and on someone else. That gets buffed. And that gets calculated for your... So if you W your whole allied team. And then you Q one of them. And then you start auto attacking. You give 300 plus heals to every one of your nearby allies. On every hit. That's pretty cool. Oh, well, great Samuro play, Void Insanity. That's a good job. Controlled the top lane. You got your Way of the Wind super fast. Finishing, three blade style. Press the attack. Cool. And I was going to go for Divine Protection, which means you can get 50% armor on everyone that you are healing. And with Beacon of Light, correct me if I'm wrong, you're healing everyone every auto attack. So everyone around you has armor? Is that true? Am I wrong? Devotion specifies it has to be healing from basic abilities. Okay. Thank God. Okay, so we take that crazy tier away. No. Okay, so it's only from your basics. So if you W your whole team and you Q one person, you got 25, 25, 25, 50 armor. That makes sense. So, there is a lot to be optimized about the way you play with Uther, and who you heal, when you heal them, how much time in between two heals. So he's a skillful hero in that sense. But he's also straightforward in the sense that you kind of just throw your stuff and kill and heal people. He's a frontline warrior. When you die, you still get value for your team. Yeah, you yourself should get 25 armor. You're right. You'll always get 50 armor for yourself as well. Because both Q and W always self-heal. Except if you had no damage. Benediction W into W is 50 armor for everyone. Oh, that's a good point, Greybender. Double W is 50 armor for everyone, if you manage to hit everyone. That's sick. And I like Hand of Protection. And I probably like Hand of Protection more than the other level 7s. I'll just show you one more time. And I guess it is situational. But you can get stunned, rooted, or silenced all day as Uther. I'm not sure that makes you happy. But if it does happen to you, you're going to cast a lot of Holy Lights. Does that make you happy? Are you going to walk into Malfroot just to get faster Holy Light back? Maybe yes. This is 200% faster. That's triple the speed. So you can walk into a Malfroot on purpose. And you get triple the Q cooldown for 6 seconds. That's a lot of heal for yourself, because every time you Q an ally, you heal yourself as well. And you give armor to everyone. This one is like, instead of cleanse, you make someone get a hardened shield. But you must heal them as they are stunned or rooted. And it will then have a 2 second effect. Not after. Right as they are stunned, rooted, or silenced. Pretty cool. Hand of Protection works the exact same way as Cleanse. It's only the time that they played with. On Uther's trait, this effect does not stack with itself. Yes, but his level 20 allows it to stack. We got something out of that. That's good.
I am the soul in the shadows.
So you don't dismount from it, from picking up that thing. They did really well to do so. Okay, bottom one is contested. Let's go over there. This is Vision. Let's just cast it. Oh, look at this. This is where they are. Apparently.
Payload firing upon enemy core.